a psychological warfare. Because all what they do is psychological. Mm-hmm. When they go and intimidate our citizens, it's psychological. I was just watching a video from Bamenda where these gendarmes took out this man driving his family. I think they were going to church because the children were in the car. And somebody were talking about going to church. They took him out of his car and make him walk on his knees. Have you seen that video? Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
they made him walk on his knees.
His inhuman treatment is above others.
Until the daughters couldn't bear it, they came out and pleaded. After the man has walked like half a mile on his knees, or quarter of a mile, he walked quite a distance. Mm-hmm.
The man was moved out of the car with the son and the daughter. So that is the daughter approaching them, and that is also the son approaching them. There's the daughter, I'm sure the daughter is trying to beg the policeman. The doctor is trying to beg the policeman. He's trying to beg the policeman that he should let the father go. The daughter is trying to beg the policeman. The daughter is trying to beg the policeman. After that, the policeman has let her because the daughter is now crying. The daughter is crying. Sorry. For no just good reason, the man was just moved out of the car and was just being humiliated like that. Where is this country heading to?
That is psychological warfare. It will let you know that you are not a human being. Because I've told people before, La République troops are French troops, which means that they're colonial troops from all of Africa. And their goal is to intimidate and suppress the population so that they can milk your resources.
Marcelino, ask me a question. Jesus. Oh God.
And so that's what rubbing people in the mud, having them walk on their knees, that's psychological warfare. They want to defeat you psychologically so that you succumb to them and you live in fear, and then they do what they want to do. But I'm glad that you really captured that really quick.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, we know these people. We know what they are trying to do. But the spirit of our people is more than that psychological warfare that they think that they can win. Because the people are resolute. The people know exactly where they are going. And I can guarantee you, those children that watch their father walk on his knees in humiliation in front of that so-called law and order officer, what do you think those children, what is the message to those children? Do you think that those children will grow up respecting that person from La République?
Well, I was going to say they'll never forget that.
Exactly. That is what is ingrained in their mind. And that is how they are going to see this system. And those people will be ready to fight tomorrow. So as they are in our territories thinking that they are creating order and peace, they are reinforcing the idea that they are not wanted by our people, by their own actions. So those children have taken a lesson. Even if their father have not been talking to them about this struggle, they themselves have seen, they are out of school, They have seen the reason why they are out of school by the treatment that their father has just been subjected to this morning. So those children will be ready tomorrow to take over from where their father left if their father does not finish this fight this time around.
Do you think if those children are in trouble, if there's a burglar in their home, you think they'll call the police?
Why would they call the police? Because the police will come and steal from them. You have seen them going around extorting money from people. You heard in Munyenge, they seized more than 15 million francs from those farmers in Munyenge. Why? They knew it's cocoa season. They know the people have been selling their crops. So they go in not to do anything. I got reports from Bamenda that they are breaking into people's houses in the morning and threatening to seize people, forcing people to bribe so that they should not be taken to jail. They should not be taken and locked up. So they are not doing anything but trying to extort money from people. So it is not any... I am surprised that some stupid guy like Issa Chiruma or the French ambassador, as they call them, who call these people forces of law and order. What kind of law and order? Somebody that breaks into your house in the morning and threatens your family and extorts money from you is a person who is keeping the peace. That is not a peace officer. That is a terrorist. That is a thief. That is an extortionist. That is who they are.